Hello, my dear all SSLC students. In this video, I'm going to discuss about electronic configuration. Electron vinyasa. Bere bere elements inna electron vinyasa bariyudu hege. Adra bagge, let us discuss in this video. So what is this electronic configuration? It is a distribution of electrons in an atom. So atom in a olage electrons kudu yav thara distribute agide. That we have to discuss. See, before getting into the topic, let me explain you the meaning of an atom. So what is an atom? It is the smallest particle of an element. Huda undu atom anta helidre adu elementina atyanta sanna dadanta undu kana. Okay. Now, if you consider an atom like this, at the center of the atom you have a nucleus. This is nucleus, and inside the nucleus you have protons as well as neutrons. And what about the electrons? Electrons are revolving around the circular, around the nucleus in a circular path called orbits. So these circular path, they are called as orbits. The circular path ane helthave orbits athava kakshe anta helthiri. Okay, so the electrons, the negatively charged particles, they are revolving around the nucleus in a definite path called orbits. And you are very familiar with the different shells, right? K shell, L, M, N, and so on. So the first shell, this is the first shell or a first circular orbit, it is termed as K shell. The second shell is L shell, and the third shell is M. And if you consider one more shell around the nucleus, then it will be N shell, and so on. Okay. Now, inside the shell, so if you consider a K shell here, one more subshell is present. It is called S subshell, or we can also call it as orbital. Orbital. So K annuvantadu kavacha adra adra upakavacha anta helthirala, that is S orbital. The second shell is L shell. So inside the L shell you have two subshells, S and P. And if you consider the third shell, then there are three subshells, more upakavachagal irthade, S, P, D. And if you consider the fourth shell, that is N shell, it contains S, P, D and F subshells. So this is about shells as well as subshells. Okay. I already told there are different shells such as K shell, L, M, N. Okay. So in K shell, that is the first shell surrounding the nucleus. In this shell, maximum of two electrons can accommodate. Hoda K shell alli maximum erdu electrons fill aagabodu. The second shell is a L shell. Maximum of 8 electrons can accommodate. That means, see, in K shell only one subshell is present, which is that S subshell. How the K kavachadalli inond upakavacha yavudu? S subshell athava S orbital anta helthave. So even in S orbital only maximum of 2 electrons can accommodate. So in other words, K shell or in S orbital, maximum of 2 electrons can accommodate. If you consider the second shell, that is a L shell. In L shell, there are 2 subshells, S and P. So in S orbital or S subshell, 2 electrons, the capacity of this that particular orbital or a subshell, S upakavachada, maximum capacity is 2 electrons. P orbital is 6 electrons. Therefore, total of 2 plus 6, 8 electrons can accommodate in the second shell. If you consider the third shell, M shell, so there are three subshells S, P, D. So in S orbital, maximum of 2 electrons can accommodate. In P orbital, maximum of 6 electrons can accommodate. In D orbitals, maximum of 10 electrons. The total 2 plus 6 plus 10, it will be 18. So the maximum capacity of the third shell, that is M shell, this is 18. If you consider the fourth shell, N shell, there are four subshells, nalku upakavashagalive, avugalu yavudu, S, P, D and F. Once again, S orbital, erdu electrons fill agabodu, P orbital alli 6 electrons, D orbital alli 10 electrons and the F orbital alli 14 electrons fill agabodu. So if you go and add these numbers or number of electrons, 2 plus 6, 8 plus 10, 18, 18 plus 14, it will be equal to 32. So in N shell, maximum of 32 electrons can accommodate. Now let us write the electronic configuration of elements one by one. So first I'll consider hydrogen. What is atomic number? Paramanu sankhye eshtu? Ondu. That means atomic number is equal to 1, which indicates the number of protons, which is equal to the number of electrons. Okay. So let us write the electronic configuration. See, if you are considering this as an atom, so you need to fill the electrons in orbits, in circular path, isn't it? So first you have to consider the first shell. This is one. This is second shell. This is third shell. Okay, I'll write it like this. One. How many electrons are there in hydrogen? Only one electron. So where it goes? It goes to the first shell. In first shell, that means that is a K shell. That is K shell. Which is a subshell present? Yes, subshell. So I'll write 1 as, so the maximum here only one electron is present. So the configuration is 1s1. Or sometimes in your textbook, in your 10th textbook, you have the configuration like this. In K shell, the number of electron present is only 1. Okay. Next, if you consider the next element, that is helium, what is atomic number? 2. That means there are 2 electrons. Let us write the electronic configuration. So first you have to consider the first shell, that is K shell, which is a subshell, S shell. How many electrons can accommodate? Since there are 2 electrons, so maximum there are 2 electrons can occupy the first shell. Next element, if you consider lithium, what is atomic number? 3. So let us write the electronic configuration. The first thing you have to consider the first shell itself, because which is nearer to the nucleus and it is having lower energy. So always the electrons should go to the lower energy orbital first. Still one electron is remaining. So next it enters into the second shell. Why not possible in first shell? Because the maximum capacity of the S orbital is only 2. More than 2 electrons cannot accommodate in the same shell. So next it goes to the second shell. You have to mention it as 2, which is a subshell present in a L shell, that is in a second shell, that is S and P. So in you have already studied in L shell, we have S and P orbital. That means the second shell, first electron goes to S orbital, only one electron. So the total number of electrons now equal to 3. 1s2, 2s1. Next, after lithium, it is a beryllium. Element is beryllium. What is atomic number? It is 4. So let us write the electronic configuration. 1s2. 2s2. After beryllium, it is boron, atomic number 5. So 1s2. Next, it goes to the second shell. First, it enters into the s orbital, only 2 electrons capacity, or maximum it can accommodate 2 electrons, not more than that. So still 1 electron is remaining. Where it enters to the p orbital, which is there in the second shell itself, 2p hurt, right? 2p, 1s2, 2s2, 2p1. Next, it is carbon. Atomic number is 6. Electronic configuration 1s2, 2s2. After that, 2 electrons remaining, it enters into 2p orbital. After carbon, if you consider the next element, then it is nitrogen. What is atomic number 7? So let us write the electronic configuration 1s2, 2s2. Next, it is 2p. Already 4 electrons are over. Remaining is 3 electrons. After nitrogen, the element is oxygen with atomic number 8. Let us write the electronic configuration 1s2, 2s2, 2p4. Isn't it? After oxygen, next it is fluorine with atomic number 9. Ili hogtade 1s2, 2s2, 2p5 ge hogtade yake p orbital alli maximum 6 electrons kutkolabodu. So next it is neon, atomic number 10. What is the configuration? 1s2, 2s2, 2p6. Okay, I hope all of you have understood the concept. After neon, let us write the electronic configuration by yourself. Okay, thank you.